Open up your Bibles to Ezekiel chapter 1. Tonight I'll be teaching to you about electricity. Electricity. Okay. Now, in the Bible, unless you study deeply and search the scriptures, you will find what the Bible talks concerning about electricity. The closest that you'll probably get into is concerning the word lightning in your Bible. It will be the word lightning in your Bible. Now, when you look up the word lightning in your King James Bible, a lot of times some people might think that lightning is a positive connotation in your Bible because a lot of it can be associated with what God's doing, His miraculous mighty work. But actually, electricity or lightning in the Bible is mostly a negative connotation in the scriptures. So I want you to understand that. You might say, why is it such a negative connotation in the Bible when lightning is associated with the presence of God? Because every time, if not every time, nearly every time in your Bible that you look up the word lightning, it is associated with something negative, not positive. Even though it's associated with God, it's associated with His magnificent power that puts terror and fear in people. It is the point of lightning or electricity is that it's a destructive force, not a happy force. That's the point of this lightning, is that it's a destructive force, not a happy force. So with God, the reason why lightning would show the awesome power of God is because of its destructive, energetic power. So that's what you want to understand concerning lightning. So look up the word lightning in your King James Bible, and it will quite often, most of the time, associate itself with a destructive force. Now think about it. If it's a destructive force, who would be a great fan of destruction? Wouldn't Satan be a great fan of destruction? Because Satan is a great fan of destruction, we do know that lightning, just like the serpent, is part of God's creation. And everything that God makes is good. However, Satan takes the good creation of God, whether it be lightning or serpent, and takes the negative, any kind of negative attribute from it to turn it into something negative. That's what you got to understand. So Satan would love the lightning because of its destructive force. Its destructive force would complete his goal concerning about murder, for example. The Bible says that he is a murderer from the beginning, right? So because he is a murderer from the beginning, of course he would love the lightning. Now, let's look at several passages. First of all is Ezekiel chapter 1. We're going to look at the four cherubs. Open up your Bible to Ezekiel chapter 28 as well. Ezekiel chapter 28. Now the cherubs, they are associated with the power of lightning. Look at verse 13, Ezekiel chapter 1 and verse 13. Now notice already you already have a negative number. The number 13, the unlucky number. That's Satan's favorite number. One of Satan's favorite number is the number 13. And at verse 13, it talks about the lightning. The Bible says, as for the likeness of the living creatures, their appearance was like burning coals of fire and like the appearance of lamps. It went up and down among the living creatures, and the fire was bright, and out of the fire went forth what? Lightning. So, out of these four cherubs came out lightning. For some of you who do not notice the cherubs, you can notice that the cherubs are described when you look at verse 5, when you look at verse 5, it would talk about the four cherubs, and verse 10, the four faces. Now we look at Ezekiel chapter 28. Ezekiel chapter 28. Keep your hand in Ezekiel 1. So if cherubs are associated with lightning, wouldn't Satan be associated with lightning? He will absolutely be associated with lightning, just like these cherubs. So we're going to look at several passages in your Bible that's going to show how Satan is known to be a cherub. The Bible says in Ezekiel chapter 28 and verse 13, thou hast been in Eden, the garden of God. All right, who is this spiritual being that went to Eden a long time ago? Look at verse 15. Thou wast perfect in thy ways from the day that thou wast created till iniquity was found in thee. Wait a minute, who is this spiritual being who was perfect, who's been in Eden, but fell due to his sin? Why? That's Satan. Now keep reading. By the multitude of thy merchandise they have filled the midst of thee with violence, and thou hast sinned. Therefore I will cast thee as profane out of the mountain of God, and I will destroy thee, O what? Covering cherub, from the midst of the stones of fire. So Satan is described to be as the covering cherub. Now go back to Ezekiel chapter 1. This is something to note here concerning about these four cherubim. The four cherubim, you're going to notice that they have some certain features from their face. Ezekiel chapter 1 and verse 10. As for the likeness of their faces, they four had the face of a man and the face of a lion on the right side. And they four had the face of a what?
Ox
on the left side. They four also had the face of an eagle. Did you notice that? Now keep your hand in Ezekiel 1. Go to Ezekiel 10. Ezekiel chapter 10. Verse 14. Remember the order here. The order of these four cherubs is as follows. We see ox, we see man, we see eagle, and we see lion. These are the four faces, right? Now look at what your King James Bible says at Ezekiel chapter 10. Verse 14, and everyone had four faces. The first face was the face of a what? Whatever cherub is. The second face was the face of a man. Check. The third, the face of a lion. Check. The fourth, the face of an eagle. Check. Wait a minute. Then ox is also known to be as what?
Cherub.
Now notice that this ox is known to be a cherub. Now, Quinky Dinky, look at this. Animal that has horns. And this animal that has horns just so happened to match with this demonic being who is infamous to have horns. Ain't that interesting? I'm going to show you something else that's more interesting. Go to the book of Luke. Luke chapter 10. Luke chapter 10. Now we know that Satan, he's a fallen cherub. The Lord no longer has him up in heaven. And notice how the Lord Jesus Christ describes the cherub. We're going to look at the book of Luke, chapter 10. Luke chapter 10. Now, Jesus Christ, he describes the devil as follows. Verse 18. Verse 18. Notice what Satan is known to be as. Jesus words it, and he said unto them, I beheld Satan as what? Lightning fall from heaven. So Satan is described by Jesus Christ when he fell as lightning falling from heaven. Wow, so this demonic creature is associated with lightning. He is associated with electricity. Go back to Ezekiel 1, please. Ezekiel chapter 1. He is certainly described as an association with electricity. Because as a cherub, he has connections and powers with electricity. That's why Jesus beheld him as lightning falling from heaven, Satan. Now, that's possible for the devil because of his cherub status, right? Because of his cherub status, he has this. You look at pagan demonic gods throughout history, you know of a certain god which is known among the ancient Greeks to be the chief of gods. And this chief of gods, he is known as his power to be with thunder and lightning, Zeus. Did you know that if you look at the god Zeus, that some of them would show you how Zeus is depicted when he came down on earth? He came down with the head of an ox. How about that? There's something weird going on here. Some people, I mean, look at this, these horns. Don't they look like an antenna, for example? Look at that. Maybe there's a connection here for some weird reason.
Interesting.
I don't know what's going on, but they make the connections with bull and lightning with the devil. Another thing concerning why Satan, he is known to be as a satanic creature. I don't know if you knew this, but Anton LaVey, who is infamous with his satanic ties, he always wore this type of necklace that people knew. And then the Church of Satan, it was actually a very special pendant they seen it as. But it was a picture of an upside down pentagram. But what goes down? Now, we know what this is, right?
Yeah.
See this horned creature? Look at this. So imitating like Baphomet a little bit. So some people say that the upside down pentagram, especially in masonry, is very similar to Baphomet, who's a demonic creature. But look at these horns. See that? These horns that he has? And the Satanists, coincidentally, they just put a lightning symbol like that. And there's your pendant. Right? Where the horns are at. Isn't that interesting? What is that supposed to represent? What's supposed to represent, now this is a website, which I obviously don't recommend, but it's by the Satanists, and the Satanists describe their own satanic symbol. So let's look what they say. So we're not going to look at other sources. We're going to look at what the Satanists themselves describe it as. So this is from satanslibrary.org, and the title is Satanic Symbols, Satanic Symbols. The following is described concerning about the satanic sign. The point down pentagram symbolizes energy entering our crown chakra from above. Okay, so remember that. That's something that's new age, right? Your crown chakra from above here. So let's take a look into this a little later on. The satanic lightning bolt symbolizes Satan as our true creator God. The lightning bolt is the life force. The bioelectricity. All point down symbols in Satanism represent energy from above, descending and giving life to and empowering the human soul. Isn't that interesting? So they believe that lightning has to do with giving energy. Now, what do you live in a day and age of? You cannot have life today in dead objects unless you have something, and that is electricity. You need lightning. This is supposed to give you life. Wait a minute. In the Bible, it's the total opposite. In the Bible, how God uses it is destruction. Satanic or Satanism itself always does things backwards, don't they?
Right,
right. God up in heaven, whenever he uses the lightning, it shows the magnificence of his power and the scary, awesome might of it, where it associates with destruction, great mass and power. But then the Satanists, they take this where it will be associated with life, not death. Look up in your Bible about lightning. People get scared of the lightning. Why? Go near the lightning. See if you're alive after that. Everyone knows you're going to get killed. There's something strange concerning about electricity. So this is what the Satanists teach concerning about lightning and electricity And Anton LaVey was infamous concerning that. And some actually say that to enter a higher satanic level of, I think, what they call the priesthood, then these high officials, these high-ranking Satanists will wear this kind of pendant that's similar to Anton LaVey. My. Let's look at some other scriptural passages. Back to Ezekiel 1. If you want to talk about UFOs in the Bible, mention of UFO in the Bible will be Ezekiel chapter 1. Ezekiel chapter 1. Let me know when I'm out of bounds. But in Ezekiel chapter 1, there's your mention of UFOs. And these UFOs, basically, what does UFO stand for? Unidentified flying object. It's basically some kind of machine that flies that we cannot identify. And it's a circular pattern for some weird reason. Does the Bible talk about an unidentified object that flies around and is a circular pattern? Well, Ezekiel chapter 1, look at this. We read verse 13, the lightning that came out, right? But look at this one, verse 14. And the living creatures ran and returned as the appearance of a what? Flash of lightning. Now as I beheld the living creatures, behold, one wheel upon the earth by the living creatures with his four faces. Look at that. There's a wheel that follows along with them when they go and disappear through like a flash of lightning. Now, when you talk about unidentified flying objects, and then some people talk about how hot the machine or the devices are, or through this flash of beam light that movies display, that it's like quick like that, a flash, like a flash of lightning or something like that, and the person just gets transported up into the spaceship. And then you get these people who became mentally broken down because they've claimed that they've encountered aliens or were stolen by aliens. And it's very disturbing when you hear their stories and their testimonies about some of the similar patterns that they went through, how they saw these aliens and what they did to them, and etc. It's very disturbing. So, UFOs, Satan can be flying these throughout outer space in our world today. He can. Because why? He is the cherub. And as the cherub, he has the power. He has the power to use these wheel-like objects. The lightning. Okay. He can have these things flying up your heads right now where you least expect it. How many people are talking about the UFOs becoming real now? Ever since that landing inside Hawaii, down the ocean. And then Harvard chairman on astronomy, if I recall, and then some intelligent agents are now coming out recently, within the past 5 years, that this is actually real. Intelligence life is real now. Man, Satan's preparing for something. What's he preparing? So that he can come down like lightning one day, perhaps, through this UFO, and then declare himself to be God, providing life. Why? Because our technology and resources is scarce. We need to borrow energy from somebody else. Especially since, look, technology will not run without one source, and that's electricity. You need electricity. Now let's go to other passages. Go to Job, book of Job. Let's talk about the ancients now. We talked about sci-fi stuff, a little bit about the future. Go to Job 41. Now let's talk a little bit more on mythology. We talked about Zeus. Before mankind ever had electricity, they knew that electricity existed. And if you go back to Egypt, wait a minute, back to Egypt. Egypt is where all this strange stuff is going on. The strange stuff about who built the pyramids. Well, was Satan's creatures that created the pyramids that time. So if they created the pyramids of that time, Then the question goes, some of electricity that is associated with these unidentified flying objects, they could have granted it to the Egyptians. You should read some stories about that. It will just blow your socks off about Egyptians getting their source of electricity. But one of the interesting things, which is historical fact, is that the Egyptians figured out electricity, that it did exist, because of water creatures, fish, who displayed electric-like symptoms. But that's not a problem now with some of us. We know that later on in life, we found more types of fish that can give off electricity vibes, and that's famously the eel. Now, isn't that interesting? A water creature that's connected to electricity. And the eel looks like a snake-like water creature, is he not? Who is known as the water serpent? Leviathan. Go back to Leviathan here. Leviathan. Go to Job chapter 41. Job 41. It's Leviathan. The Bible says, "Canst thou draw out Leviathan with an hook, or his tongue with the cord which thou lettest down?" So we know Satan is a Leviathan, but isn't it interesting, son, the words can appear to be as electricity, perhaps. Look at a few examples about the Leviathan. The Bible says, let's see here. Verse 16, "One is so near to another that no air can come between them. They are joined one to another, they stick together, that they cannot be sundered. By his kneesings a what? Light doth shine. And his eyes are like the what? Eyelids of the morning." How about that? So there's some kind of electricity perhaps that's displayed out of him. But there's no doubt it's light that comes out. Some energy. There's no doubt there's some kind of energy source in him that shows light. That's the point. Here's some other pointers here. It reads, verse 31, "He maketh the deep to boil like a pot. He maketh the sea like a pot of ointment. He maketh the pass to what?
Shine
after him. One would think the deep to be hoary." How about that? There's something he's leaving a trace behind, and he makes the path shine ahead of him. So notice that the Bible indicates some type of electric type symptoms that this Leviathan has. The Leviathan, as you know, is Satan. If you look at the book of Revelation chapter 12, which I won't turn to, but if you look at Revelation chapter 12, we know that Leviathan, that he is known to be as Satan and the serpent. If you compare that with the book of Isaiah as well, you will see that the Bible calls the Leviathan the crooked serpent. Great. The dragon that is in the sea. So way, way back then, you get this scary, horrifying creature. And rightfully so, because this is referring to Satan himself. An eel, like a serpent creature giving electricity. A lot of interesting stuff. Satan, he is connected as a water creature. You notice that in the Bible, he is connected as an animal to water. He is connected to water reptile-like creatures. Water reptiles. It's always water reptile. We're going to look at 2 Corinthians chapter 10 now. 2 Corinthians chapter 10. And then 2 Corinthians chapter 2. Go to 2 Corinthians chapter 2 and 2 Corinthians chapter 10. Mm. Now we know that electricity, it can give life in the sense where some of you probably already know this, your nervous system. Your nervous system, that's how the neurons can transport and your mind can start thinking and firing, and it's like electric-like symptoms that are shooting out. So you might think that as, well, that should be something positive then, electricity. Because inside us we have electricity, so to speak. That's why we can think, we can make decisions, we can live and breathe. But there's something you don't understand. So yeah, you might think in one sense here, you might think at one sense here that this seems to be a good thing within people because of the brain. It gives us life. But you're not using your heads here because who's the one that takes advantage of this electricity in your mind to spiritually attack you? And you know what the Bible calls that? Go to 2 Corinthians 10. 2 Corinthians chapter 10. So yeah, there are some positive things within God's creation about lightning, but you got to realize this is that Satan, he always takes advantage of God's creation and turn it into something bad. That's why electricity is mostly, you're going to find out it's usually bad. Go to 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 5. Casting down what? Imaginations. That electricity firing within you. Your mind. And every what? High thing that exalteth itself against the knowledge of God. That's referring to devils. Didn't you know that? Because keep your hand here. Go to Ephesians chapter 6. Keep your hand here. Go to Ephesians 6. High thing. That's referring to devils. Go to Ephesians chapter 6. That's why the Bible says the imagination of the heart was only what? Evil continually. That's what the Bible says. Because it's all under the control of Satan himself. He controls people's minds. That's why you'll get that demonic thought in your mind that you need to plead the blood over. It's a demonic mind that enters in the middle of prayer. That's a power. Wow. That's a dark power. It's a power that messes up in the middle of church service and puts something in your mind in the middle of preaching. Oh, he's talking about you, so he doesn't know what he's talking about. Oh, the preacher's too mean, or that doctrine is too crazy. That's the devil.
Amen.
Look at Ephesians chapter 6.
Amen.
Amen, brother. Amen. Go to Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against, see, demons, against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in what?
High places.
High places.
Wow.
That matches. Go back to 2 Corinthians 10, 5. If you look at verse 4, that matches with Ephesians 6, verse 4. Our warfare is not against flesh and blood, it's something spiritual. See that?
Amen.
2 Corinthians 10, 4. That matches to a T with Ephesians 6. There is no doubt about that. So keep reading verse 5. Every high thing that exalteth itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the what?
Obedience
of Christ. It is so important. You're in spiritual warfare with the electricity that's going on in your flesh.
Right. Amen.
And that is a negative connotation. A lot of times it's a negative connotation. So then, what does the Bible want us to do with our minds? It doesn't perceive it as something fleshly. Because of your flesh is evil, nothing good. It's from the Spirit. Go to Romans 12. Romans 12. How God sees the power of the mind is not through your flesh. Because the flesh, there's nothing good in it. It will be of the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, the spiritual nature inside you. So that's where your mind has to be renewed. It has to be renewed from the Holy Spirit of God.
Amen.
It comes from Him, friend.
Amen.
Now, look at Romans chapter 12, verse 2. Be not conformed to this world, but be what?
Transformed
by the renewing of your mind. Look at that. God, he wants to renew your mind. Why? The electricity that's running in your mind, he knows that's all fleshly. You need to renew that. You need to reset it. That's why a lot of neurologists and people who are interested in neurology or brain processes, they mention that the mind is already built at a pattern from birth, where if, especially if it's addicted to drugs, you're already a drug addict mind. In order to fix that, you need to reprogram your brain. So in order to reprogram your brain is just like how you did from birth till now by your action, you need to do that. How you change your thinking, you need to do that. And then the brain is actually reset. That is actually scientifically proven and possible. So the mind can be renewed. The brain can be reset to something different. But see, it needs the power of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
It needs the power of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit, it needs to be spiritually renewed.
Amen.
And it can't be conformed to the pattern of the world that you're at. That's where your mind is set in. Notice it says transformed. See that? Renewed. You need to change it. You need to transform and change it. Let's look at a positive thing of what Jesus Christ is. Jesus Christ, he's not known to be as light. He is lightning. He is not known to be as lightning. He is known to be as light. Go to John 1. John chapter 1. Jesus Christ is not known to be lightning. He is known to be light. That's why there's a song that the light of the world is Jesus. Some scientists argue that you can get energy and life from light as well. Ah, then we have a competition here. You either get your energy or your life from the light, or you can get it from the lightning. Go to John chapter 1. Notice what the Bible says in verse 4. In him was life, and the life was the what?
The
light of men. And the light shineth in darkness. The darkness comprehended it not. Keep reading. Verse 9. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. Isn't that amazing? That's Jesus Christ. Go to Satan's job is to corrupt that. Go to 2 Corinthians 4. 2 Corinthians chapter 4. There's a saying. The word of God is light. But you reject light, it becomes lightning. And rejected light becomes lightning. And what is lightning referred to as? Destruction. Bam! Like that. So when lightning is associated with God, it would point it out as destruction. But with life and enlightenment, the Lord will use light. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 4. In whom the God of this world hath blinded the minds of them which believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them. So Satan's job is to be in the dark. Now, he is lightning. We see a lot of his associations with lightning, but you got to realize this. The reason why he has to have his power of lightning running is because he's in the dark. He is not light. Satan is not light. Jesus Christ is light. Satan is of darkness, and he doesn't like that. So because Satan does not like that, how does he roam around in the dark? If you get electricity, if you have lightning, sometimes you see that, right? Lightning comes out. It can come out through dark clouds. Sometimes that can happen. Look at our world today. What helps you keep seeing the light in the dark? When you're of darkness and you're in the dark and you want light, guess what? You're going to have to use electricity. You're going to have to use electricity for that. These are so many interesting associations then. Look at 2 Corinthians chapter 2. Then Corinthians chapter 2. Look at our technology today. Back then, your TV looked like this. Had these two little tubes, something in the middle, whatever this doohickey is, and then it had this annoying antenna that you would play back and forth. But now it advanced. It's something where you call an iPhone, and the screen is like this wide. And then you can be able to use your little forbidden apple, so to speak. Okay, so that's a poor rendition, but the point is look at these devices in our world today. What is the fruit of these devices? The Bible says, by their fruits ye shall know them. So you'll know if it's good and evil. Ever since technology came to the scene, think about all the fruits that came out. All the fruits that came out. Do you think that and if you're a very honest person, you know the majority that when you use electricity is mostly used to satisfy your flesh.
Amen.
It is used for Satan's purpose.
Right.
You know how you brainwash people about everything that's going on with COVID and evolution and what's going on with the Democrat Party and etc. And why Christians are a joke and they're wicked evil people that are associated with riots that you should be careful of. This demon possessed guy. So think about demon-possessed people, Mark Zuckerberg on Facebook, Twitter, and then you get Instagram, and then you get Google, and you get all these criminals. Yeah, I said that. You get these demonic criminals used by the devil. If some people get upset at me for saying that, spiritually speaking, all right? Don't kick me out, please. Spiritually speaking, criminals used by the devil where they can control information. And they control information and give it to you in a pattern and a way where CNN and Associated Press and then all these liberal news reporters, they can dominate the platform, and anything you want to find out about real news or what's really going on, you type it on Google, it'll be a liberal agenda posted in front of your face. That is a fruit of technology. Look at the fruit of technology. It satisfies your flesh all the time. Where did you learn cuss words that you never heard before, dress the way that you never heard before, the music garbage that you never heard before until these guys came to the scene? Until Hollywood came to the scene. That's where you learned that garbage from. You raise your kids right and they talk about something and you go, where'd you learn that? I didn't teach you that. They've been watching something, learning something. Something sexual, something violent doesn't go to past teenage years anymore, past 18. It goes all the way down where you can reach to 10 to 9-year-olds now that are talking about it. That's messed up. That is a messed up generation. That's the fruit. Look, and isn't it interesting how the Bible words about Satan at 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 11. Lest Satan should get an advantage of us, for we are not ignorant of his what?
Devices.
Oh, look at that. These qualify as his devices. They just qualify so well. That just qualifies so well. Devices. Beautiful word. Don't be ignorant of these devices. Watch out for these wicked guys. And look at the history of electricity is very interesting. The big names are associated with electricity. You'll find some kind of satanic connection and weird stories involved. For example, Benjamin Franklin is one of the big people that they look up to about electricity, right? When he sent that, kite out in the sky, etc. Good thing it didn't zap him to death or something. But if you look up Benjamin Franklin, guess what? This is the guy who hated George Whitefield's preaching, the Great Awakening Revival preaching. This guy, if he was not a deist, he was somehow connected with some kind of conspiracy elite as well, if it's not surprising there. Look at other people. Another example is where Thomas Alva Edison is attributed all the glory concerning about electricity, where it was born and birthed out of. But you got to think about Tesla. You got to think about Tesla as well. There are some interesting stories behind that, which you can look up concerning about Tesla and also Edison. If you look up Edison, he was part of the Theosophist Society. They had his name in their certificate. A lot of weird stuff. People who is responsible for your great electric technology today have all kinds of weird satanic connections, even if it's not deliberate. Another example, you see Apple right here, Steve Jobs? He may not be a literal Satanist, but look at this. This forbidden apple that you eat out of for greater knowledge. That was the implication. Why do you have to associate some kind of satanic thing? It's just weird. Just pretty weird. Anyway, just coincidence with everything electricity that you see nowadays attributed to the devil. Just a little bit of coincidence. Look at another example. Go to Revelation chapter 13. Ooh, here's a big one. Ready? Go to Revelation 13. And then your second hand, go to 2 Corinthians chapter 11. 2 Corinthians chapter 11. Satan, he is not light, correct? Isaiah chapter 14, they said, "How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How art thou cut down which this week the nations?" Now, Satan is known to be as Lucifer. Now, you know what your modern Bibles do, these stupid, dumb modern Bibles? They, instead of putting Lucifer, they erase that name so you can't find Lucifer in the Bible anywhere, anywhere at all. And then they replace it with Morning Star. Why, that's stupid. I'll tell you who the Morning Star is. Look at Revelation 22, and that's Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Why? Because he's the light. He's the light. You know what Lucifer means? Some people don't look at this. So right here, this is associated with light. But fur is like bearing or bringing. Why? That's all Lucy can do. All he can do is just bring it. He can bear it. He is not light itself. Jesus Christ is light. That is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Jesus Christ is light himself. All he can do is just bring the light. That's why in the darkness, all he can do with his lightning power is bring up false lights, not unnatural lights, and he has to transform himself to an angel of light. See, he is not light himself. He has to transform into that. 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 14. "And no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed into a what? Angel of light." He transforms himself into an angel of light. So he can transform into light. Why can't you Christians transform your mind with the light of Jesus Christ?
That's good.
Did you get that there?
Yeah.
Satan can transform into light. He can be a better preacher, a better Christian than you, and fake it. And guess what? He does know more Bible than you anyways. See, he can transform into light. You Christians, why can't you transform your wicked minds into the light of Jesus Christ? That's extremely dangerous that you should know about your adversary. This is a dangerous adversary here. So if you study about, this is so interesting. I read scientific journals about electricity and what they call LAN. And that's a scientific term that they use. All right. I know LAN can refer to other terms, but in this particular scientific journal, they're referring that to fake unnatural lights. And what they've studied about lights in the dark or lights that we have in the dark, that's not good for you. That's why there are people who create TV shows and then they'll warn some people in an advertisement, make sure you dim the lights, or the iPhones, they'll have the screen protector and etc. Why? Because this unnatural light is unhealthy for you. As a matter of fact, it can be even dangerous later on. It's dangerous later on. And you know what they found very, very troubling about this unnatural light? Very unhealthy and dangerous, and most actively used when? In the dark. In the dark. Jesus said, "Men love darkness rather than light." because their deeds are evil. Men love the dark. And if they want some light, they use Satan's unnatural light, which is unhealthy. Scientifically, it's unhealthy. They mention it ruins your circadian rhythm pattern, your sleep pattern. Scientific journals mention that this is very bad during darkness. During darkness, it's most active. It ruins your sleep patterns. It also is responsible, where you would not believe it, a lot of cancer that comes out. It's responsible for some of that. Wow. They talk about a lot of different cancers. And supposedly cancer is incurable too, where they talk about. And guess what contributed? This kind of adversary, who's associated with unnatural light. Very strange stuff. It can even kill you. See, it's not life, it's destruction. Technology is great. We're getting so much life out of this. No, it's killing you.
Yeah.
It's killing you that even liberals are scared of it, and they make sure they warn the people in a good liberal way and preach their liberal doctrine on how to control technology, etc. It's a plague. It is a plague. Go to Revelation 13, and we'll close it here. Now, I'm going to show you two passages we're going to close. Revelation 13 and Revelation, well, it won't be Revelation, but it'll be Matthew 24. But we won't turn there for time's sake. Let's just go to Revelation 13, and then I'll give you two interesting closes, all right? I like to always end things with two interesting things. All right, as you might know, Revelation 13. The Bible says, and he, verse 16, and he causeth all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads. Did you notice that? The mark of the beast, a lot of people get scared because it says in the forehead, right? So a lot of people will associate that with something that's technological. Electricity. Now think about this. You put this guy in your brain, and if that's true, what can it do with your mind, I wonder? Is it a wonder when you read Revelation chapter 16, the Bible says that some of these people, they get so brainwashed and dark to a point that they would not repent? This is scary stuff here. You need some kind of supernatural power of the Holy Spirit to conquer something like that. But other than that, this is something where it's you're pretty much at a point of no return, it really appears. An interesting thing, for some of you didn't know, it's in the forehead. 666 is in the forehead. Remember what those Satanists said? The lightning goes through what they call it? A crown chakra. Crown chakra. Now, let me blow up your minds here. This is a lot of stuff. If you got electricity going through your crown chakra, the crown chakra is described by others to be what they call the third eye. And then they mention that this third eye is referring to your pineal gland. Now, you know what the pineal gland is responsible for? It's for sleep, melatonin. Now, is this a wealth of information already? Let's go one by one here, all right? You already got electricity and fake light that scientific journals talk about connected, the unnatural light and electricity that does something to your melatonin that ruins your sleep cycle.
Oh, no,
so it does something right here that is totally unhealthy.
Amen.
So when people talk about, you want to open up the third eye and discuss, no, that'll kill you, okay? That will kill you. You get that electricity going right over here, you ruin the natural ability that God has given to your mind and your body. You ruin that. That is satanic from the pits of hell. Now look at this. This 666 goes where? In your forehead. It goes in your forehead. You think that's healthy? One day, because the virus is so bad, or some kind of world pandemic disease that's so bad, you need this in your forehead, and it'll be good health for you. No, it won't, man. Stay away from that. You want me to scare you a little bit more? You notice these three sixes, which is very strange, and it's very disturbing? Some people do this, right? The infamous hand the okay sign. Didn't you know? The Muslims, they talked about an Antichrist that would come out. And this Antichrist that come out, I think, was it the Mahdi or something like that? So, Mahdi, right? Okay, something like that. I don't know. But it was, they prophesied, the Muslims gave a prophecy about this Antichrist coming out, and he one eye injured. That matches with some of the Bible-believing stuff. But some of the people from the Muslim world, you know what they see this as? They see this as you're putting a curse on them. It also means evil eye. Evil eye. Open up that third eye. No! Don't open it up, man! And you know what's interesting? It's called what kind of an eye? Third eye. Look at this. You get one eye, two eye, three eye. That is screaming death to you. That is screaming destruction, not life. But that's Satan's goal and plan, is to make people think it's life. It's for your living situation. You cannot buy or sell. That's electric technology. Look at this. The latter part of verse 17. Save he that had the mark or the name of the beast or the number of his name. The first part of verse 17, that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark. You need this mark where you can buy and sell stuff. Why? Look at all the electric contraptions that we have today to buy and sell stuff. It's part of our life that we have it as. Isn't this scary stuff? By the way, sometimes, I don't know if you notice this, when people talk about, like, I'm looking at you very carefully, they do this sometimes, right? You ever know some people doing like this? That's two sixes, because you got two eyes. You just need that third eye. Add another one. So what does Jesus do, right? So Jesus, he's saying, this ain't life. I'll show you death. This is destruction. The Bible says that Matthew 24, which we won't turn to, Jesus Christ, when he comes down at Armageddon, he destroys all these people, especially those who partook in the mark of the beast system. And when he wipes them all out, the Bible says his coming is like lightning. His coming will be like the lightning. And Jesus will prove when he comes down with lightning, it's death, it's destruction, it's not life. Amen. How about that? All right, let's close with a word of prayer. God, my Father, I pray tonight's teachings have been a blessing to the hearers, opened our eyes, and I mean both of them, not the third one, Lord, but both of our eyes to the scriptures, and made us be more aware of the satanic workings around us. May our lives not be dictated through electricity. How dependent have we been upon them that they ruined us physically, as scientists have taught, they ruined us physically, our health-wise, and even spiritually, Lord. We have seen so much garbage through all the electronic devices nowadays. It's now time that we just put that down and go to church, read the Bible, and pray. It does not mean that electric devices are evil and we can use it for the good, but mostly we can see it's been used for evil, and we cannot get caught up with that. And we pray all of this in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.